your opinion, which is harder to do, levitation or teleportation?
But everything is hard to do. No, teleporting in general is a very complicated thing. It's much harder than levitation. Teleport, I consider myself a weakling in this case. I know the theory in practice. I know it on small objects. I've never been able to teleport large objects. Never touched people at all. I know my teacher used to teleport people, but again at a visible distance, so it wasn't like being sent somewhere in Africa. No, it wasn't.
You said he had drop-off, remember? Like zones.
Zones where he could go. They were places where he clearly knew where to go. But he always told me that you have to see a place. You have to see a place in the best way possible, so as not to harm the man, because the person can't disappear anyway. But you can damage him very badly. I won't go into the details of what's being damaged, but it can be damaged very badly, so it's best to...
My friends, welcome everyone to No Questions Asked. And today is an incredibly interesting topic, an incredibly important topic that all of you have been waiting for. It's the topic of teleportation.
What to say? Hello, friends. Today is really going to be an interesting topic. We're going to open the veil of mystery a little bit, but we can't tell you the whole technique. If you're interested, come to the teleportation training about the teleport. I actually only have 2 videos on my channel. In which I actually demonstrate the teleportation. One was a very old video, the other one was very recent. And we're going to watch them now.
So now I will show you the first televised teleportation with a small object. Now I will concentrate on this player. And I put the clock in to prove that there will be no pause in the video. Attention, concentration. Let's go.
Friends, it's a pleasure to welcome you. It's me again, Ernst Veter. Today I'm going to demonstrate a little bit, a slightly more complicated model of the telekinesis, and then I'm going to show you another interesting technique. Now, pay attention. I dare to disappoint many people, but many people think I am some kind of great master. In fact, I am not a great master in this subject. I know the techniques, I teach the techniques, but to my great shame, I have never done this technique with a living subject, that is, with living matter, such as an animal, a human being myself. I've done teleportation probably in the realm of 5 or 6 times in my life. 2 more of them recorded, 3 were not recorded, but it was always small objects, it was always the distance I saw. I never launched an object somewhere far away. My teacher could launch an object far away, but he had certain drop-off points for that object. To me, he just recommended it. He said, look, as long as you see it, you launch it. If you can't see it, don't launch it, because it can be very strong. First of all, living matter was forbidden to me, because it's a little bit on the level, ascending to the level of the absolute. And I don't want to go there because I have, let's say, my place in this life, and I don't want to jump above my head. About the subject matter, yes, I basically do. And I will say that it takes quite a lot of energy. I mean, it doesn't always work. Very often you just lose concentration. You can't grasp this thread on which the teleport itself goes. This is a rather complex technique which requires an incredibly deep and elaborate approach. Let me put it this way, it requires a very strong development. And a person who hasn't worked out a certain base, such as telekinesis, such as levitation, such as pyrokinesis, like fully mastering the energy of his body, they'll just run around trying to teleport when they're not ready. So this is where the really, you know, mature people come in, who've learned how to work with the basic siddhas, and then they move on to something higher. There are, of course, ones even higher than teleportation, but those are, you know, the kind of people who, okay, well, I won't go into that, into...
Ernst, in general, the subject of teleport is for many people, and for me too, it's like something, wow, that is, if levitation is wow, then teleport is wow in three huge letters. And of course, the first question I want to ask on this topic is, how difficult is it in general? I mean, if you compare it to telekinesis, to levitation, I already realized that it's complicated, but how complicated is it?
Let's, if we do it according to the rating system. For example, mastering the work of chakras is approximately equal to 30 points. Mastering the workings of telekinesis is roughly equal to 70. Pyrokinesis is about 80. Levitation is approximately 95 on a 100-point system. And teleportation is about 120, 130. So you're stepping up above that scale. Without basic skills and without the skills of certain Sith, you won't be able to do it at all. So you can know it, you can study it, you can know all the theory, but you will never cross that threshold. This particular threshold of connecting the two points, it's incredibly difficult. 120, 130 on a rating system. You know what I mean, right?
Yes. Ernst, can you teleport someone else? I mean, we've already realized that you can teleport an object, you can teleport a person. It's unrealistically difficult, but is it possible to teleport someone?
In theory you can, but in practice I've never done it. And now I can't say under the camera why, because it's a certain mystery. There are certain rules in certain circles. Again, everything is covered by secrecy. I can't say it on camera, unfortunately. Forgive me, my friends.
Ernst, the question is rather from those who have already watched your teleportation course. They will be more interested, though perhaps the rest of the audience will also learn something new. In your opinion, according to your feelings, who created the egregore of teleportation, if it is possible, of course?
No, I probably won't answer this question now, because a lot of heads may start spinning. Let's not touch it, keep it, but we're not going to answer it.
Well, should you sort of say it on camera, or did you cut it out altogether?
No. Keep it on camera, but I will say it on camera. Friends, unfortunately, there are certain Sith who, even in the line of duty, are not allowed to be discussed fully. That is, their creators, their masters, they are kept a certain secret. And some questions I am simply not allowed to answer on camera. So, forgive me, we have such an issue for today, which is a little bit silent on some points. But I really hope that I have answered some interesting questions.
Ernst, well, in that case, let's get back to more down-to-earth things, which are also very interesting because this is your experience, this is your life, your emotions. Do you remember the first emotion you experienced when you made your first teleport with some small object? What was it?
It was a tennis ball, and it was basically on a tennis court. Let's just say I felt an incredibly strong vortex. It was such a vortex, I felt like I was falling somewhere. It felt like the ground had just gone out from under my feet. So it was the launch itself that did it. But at that very moment, the moment of throwing a certain object through space, I had a feeling that I was falling down somewhere. And there was a scary feeling, an incredible feeling of fear. And to be honest, it even kind of, you know, grounded me a little bit, and I thought, if it happens to an object, what will happen to a person who is at the junction of these two points of space? And after that, I guess, I realized that I would not do it with living matter. Actually, during levitation, if you feel joy, if you feel some feeling of detachment, feeling of freedom, then during teleport, it is quite different feelings. Here you are stepping on a certain boundary, which is not given to people in principle. I think that this is where certain egregores who are trying to put us back on Earth come in, take some defense mechanisms. Friends, if you're interested in the subject of siddhas, the subject of superpowers, we are happy to tell you that we have a group where we train people. And we give training from the very beginning, meaning you get the base, which gradually progresses to siddhas such as telekinesis, pyrokinesis, levitation. At some points we will even cover higher siddhas such as teleportation. So don't miss your chance. Whoever is interested, subscribe. The link to the recording will be in the description. Friends, we will be glad to see you in our group. Friends, I thank you for your attention. I hope this information helped someone. If you were interested, put a like, subscribe to our channel, click on the bell to not miss the next issues. There will still be a lot of interesting things here. See you soon.